Now next, list of geometrical shapes. List of geometrical shapes. Here some geometrical shapes are there. Before what we did, so types of triangle, classification of triangles: equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle, scalene triangle, and right angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle, and acute angle triangle. About all these six triangles, we discussed, we learned how the types, how we classified on the basis of sides and angles, and after that the postulates, about the postulates we discuss. And after that, so list of some geometrical shapes we are going to discuss. Here, first is a square. So square, rectangle, rhombus, parallelogram, all these four geometrical shapes are two dimensional shapes. They have length and breadth. One of the dimension is length, other dimension is breadth. So we have two dimension. So in this first square, what is a square? In a square, we have four sides equal. So, four equal sides we have. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. These four sides, if four sides are equal and four angles are right angle. So, first angle, second, third, fourth. Four sides are equal and four angles are right angle. Then that is a square. Here, remember one thing. So here, how many lines of symmetry we have? We have four lines of symmetry. This is first line of symmetry. This is second line of symmetry. This is third line of symmetry. This is fourth line of symmetry. So total, how many lines of symmetries we have? Four lines of symmetries we have. If you fold lengthwise, the two parts coincide with each other. If you fold with breadthwise, then also it coincide with each other. The two parts coincide with each other. If you fold diagonal wise, first diagonal, so this is the first diagonal. If you fold diagonal wise, then the two parts coincide with each other. If you fold in second diagonal wise also, it coincide with each other. So total, how many symmetrical lines we have? Four symmetrical lines we have. What is a square? Square has four equal sides and four equal angles. Each angle is a right angle. Then after that, we have four lines of symmetry in a square. And after that, this square, all square belongs to rectangular family. All squares belongs to rectangular families, and also rhombus family, and also parallelogram family. All squares, we can say that, so it belongs to rectangular family, and also belongs to parallelogram family, and also we can call it as rhombus family. So it means square is also called as parallelogram. Square is also called as a rectangle. Square is also called as a rhombus. Okay, square is a square, but square we can call it as parallelogram as well as rectangle and also rhombus. Okay, so that is why we can say that it belongs to the three families, that is a rectangular family, parallelogram family, and rhombus family. Okay, so this is about square. So here, all these geometrical shapes, here four geometrical shapes we are going to discuss. So in these four geometrical shapes, we have four sides. How many sides we have? Four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. All are four-sided closed geometrical shapes. So all these four-sided geometrical closed shapes are called quadrilateral. So what? Quadrilaterals. So all these comes under quadrilateral family. Quadrilateral family. So rhombus is a quadrilateral, parallelogram is also a quadrilateral, rectangle is also a quadrilateral, and which one? Square is also a quadrilateral. So whatever four-sided closed geometrical figure is there, that is comes under quadrilateral family. All this quadrilateral comes under polygonal family. So three-sided closed geometrical figures are triangular family. Four-sided closed geometrical figures are quadrilateral family. Triangle as well as this quadrilateral, they comes under polygonal family. Three-sided, four-sided, five-sided, six-sided, seven-sided, eight-sided, nine-sided, all these geometrical shapes comes under polygon. We can call it as polygons. So here, separate name is there for four-sided closed figure, so that is quadrilateral. Separate name is there, but whatever is there, but this four-sided also belongs to the quadrilateral only. Okay. Now, the second, rectangle. Rectangle have four sides and four right angles. Here, opposite sides are equal in length. this side and this side equal in length, and this side and this side equal in length. And after that, four right angles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four right angles we have. How many? Four right angles we have. Four right angles, four close, four sides, and four right angles. So are there. So here opposite sides are equal in rectangle. Then in a rectangle, we have two lines of symmetries. How many? Two lines of symmetry. So lengthwise one line of symmetry is there. If you fold lengthwise, then the two parts coincide with each other. If you fold breadthwise, then the two parts coincide with each other. It means we have two lines of symmetry in a rectangle. If you fold diagonal wise, then the two parts does not coincide with each other. So that is why diagonal wise we don't have any line of symmetry. We have two lines of symmetry. One is the lengthwise, other one is the breadthwise. Okay. Next, these rectangles belongs to the parallelogram family. Only parallelogram family. But the square is belongs to parallelogram, rectangle, and rhombus family. But this rectangle is only belongs to parallelogram family. Parallelogram family. Okay. Next, rhombus. This rhombus. So in this rhombus we have four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four equal sides. Four equal sides and opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. Here the difference between square and rhombus is only one major difference is there. So in a square all four sides are equal. Here rhombus also four sides are equal. In a square all angles are equal to 90 degrees, but in rhombus that condition is not there. Okay. Here in a rhombus opposite sides are parallel and equal, and four sides are equal. This side is equal to this side is equal to this side, and this side is equal to this side. All the four sides are equal and opposite sides are parallel and equal. And this rhombus is belongs to parallelogram family. Rectangle belongs to parallelogram family, rhombus belongs to parallelogram family, square belongs to parallelogram family. All this belongs to parallelogram family only. Now here parallelogram. So here two pair of equal sides we have. This two opposite sides are parallel and equal. So this opposite sides parallel and equal. So in the both we don't have any line of, here we have two lines of symmetry. If you fold diagonal wise, then they coincide with each other. And diagonal wise, second diagonal wise, if you fold, then you coincide with each other. So in rhombus we have two lines of symmetry. How many? Two lines of. In square we have four lines of symmetry. In this rectangle we have two lines of symmetry. So here we have two lines of symmetry. In parallelogram, if parallelogram is a rectangle, we have two lines of symmetry. If parallelogram is a square, we have four lines of symmetry. If parallelogram is a rhombus, then we have two lines of symmetry. If parallelogram is a parallelogram, then we don't have any line of symmetry. We don't have any line of symmetry. So all these three are parallelograms, and also they have separate name. So all this comes under parallelogram family only. If parallelogram is a rectangle, then we have two line of symmetries. If parallelogram is a rhombus, then we have two line of symmetries. If parallelogram is a square, then we have four lines of symmetry. If parallelogram is a parallelogram, then we don't have any line of symmetry. So they have only two equal parallel sides. Equal parallel sides. Okay. So this is the concept about list of geometrical shapes. How many geometrical shapes? Four shapes. One is a square, other one is rectangle, the third one is a rhombus, and fourth one is a parallelogram. Okay. Now next here see. So list of regular polygons from 3 to 10 sides. So 3 to 10 sides, we are going to discuss about 3 to 10 sides. Okay. So 3 sided closed polygon and 4 sided closed polygon, 5 sided closed polygon, 6 sided closed polygon, 7 sided, 8 sided, 9 sided, 10 sided, till 10 sided polygon what we can say. See here. The first one, so this is a 3 sided closed polygon. So this is a triangle. This is a triangle. So this we can say that this is, so this is our equilateral triangle. So this is regular. Regular means all three sides are equal. This is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means all the three sides are equal. All the three sides are equal. If all the three sides are equal in a triangle, then that is regular polygon. Regular polygon. Say in the regular polygon, so all three sides are equal. In regular triangle, all three angles are equal to 60 degrees. 60 degrees, 60 degrees, 60 degrees. If you add 360s, the total interior angle is 180 degrees. The total interior angle in three-sided regular polygon is 180 degrees. This triangle is irregular triangle. Irregular triangle. This is irregular triangle. Why we can say that this is irregular triangle? So, because all the three sides we have different sides. So, this side is different length and this side is different length and this side is different length. If all the three sides are different in length, then that is irregular. That is irregular triangle. This is regular triangle. This is a closed, three-sided, closed geometrical polygon. So, the each angle in regular triangle is 60 degrees. So, interior three angles sum is always 180 degrees. Okay. This is about three-sided. Now, four-sided. So, four-sided regular polygon. We can say that. So, what we can say? It is square. Four-sided regular polygon is square. So, this is also called quadrilateral. Four-sided regular polygon is called square. Now, in this we have four angles are equal. All angles are right angles. 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. If you add four angles, 90 plus 90 plus 90 plus 90, that is equal to 360 degrees. Here, so beside that one more polygon is given, that is irregular polygon. Irregular polygon, that is four-sided, no, irregular. Irregular quadrilateral. This is irregular. This is regular quadrilateral, that is a square. Irregular quadrilateral, that is irregular quadrilateral. Irregular means, so unequal sides. So, they have unequal sides, unequal angles. So, regular means equal sides, equal angles. All sides are equal and all angles are equal, that is regular. Irregular means all sides are different and all angles are different. So, that is irregular. Now, here after that, four-sided is over. Now, five-sided closed geometrical polygon. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here also we have four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, what is the difference between this and this? So, this is a regular and this is irregular. So, regular five-sided polygon is called pentagon. This is pentagon. This is pentagon. And what it is? It is also pentagon, but that is irregular pentagon. But that is irregular pentagon. Irregular. So, right here, irregular pentagon. This is regular pentagon, this is irregular pentagon. Regular means five equal sides, five equal angles. So, all angles, each angle is equal to 108 degrees and five equal angles, 108. If you add five times 108, then you will get 540. Each angle is equal to 108, means 108. A five sides, five equal sides and five equal angles there. So, that is why this is regular pentagon, this is irregular pentagon. Either it is a regular or irregular. So, interior angle, sum of interior angles is 540 only. But in regular, all five angles are equal to 108. In irregular angles there. Okay. This is the difference between regular and irregular. Regular means all sides are equal and all angles are equal. Okay. Now, pentagon is over. Now, this one. How many sides we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 sides. 6 sides means hexagon. This is regular hexagon. So then this one is irregular hexagon. So in this we have irregular sides. Irregular sides. Here irregular. Irregular hexagon. In regular hexagon, all 7 sides, all 6 sides are equal, all 6 sides are equal, and all 6 angles are equal. So each angle is 120 degrees. 120, 120, 120, 120, 120, 120. If you add all 6 angles, that sum is 720 degrees. 720 degrees. Sum of all 6 angles is 720 degrees. And each angle is 120. 120 here, 120, 120, 120, 120, 120. But in irregular, sum of all the 6 angles is 720, but they are not unequal. They are not equal. All are different angles. So all sides are different, all angles are different in irregular. Then after that, hexagon. Now here, how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 sides here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sides. So all these two have 7 sides. 7 sides means heptagon. That is 7 sided closed. Polygon is a heptagon. So this is regular heptagon. This is regular heptagon. This is irregular heptagon. This is irregular heptagon. In regular heptagon, all 4 sides are equal and all 4 angles are equal. So each angle is equal to 128.6 degrees. 128.6 degrees each angle. If you add all 7 angles, that sum is 900 degrees. 900 degrees. Sum of 7 angles. Sum of 7 angles. 128.6 plus 128.6 plus 128.6. If you add 7 times, that sum is 900 degrees. Okay. Regular means sides and angles are same. Now, here how many sides we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8-sided. This is a octagon. This is irregular octagon. Octagon. Irregular. This is irregular octagon. This is regular octagon. This is irregular octagon. In regular octagon, all 8 sides are same and 8 angles are equal. So each angle is 135 degrees. If you add 135 8 times, that sum is 1080. This is octagon. Regular and irregular. Then nonagon. Then here, how many sides we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So only 8 sides we have to draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more side we have to draw. Okay. So don't draw 10 sides. Only 9 sides we have to draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. How many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 sides. Here how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 sides. This is regular nonagon. This is irregular nonagon. Irregular nonagon. This is nonagon. Nonagon. This is irregular nonagon. Okay. This is regular. This is irregular. Regular means all sides are equal and all angles are equal. each angle is 140 degrees. If you add 140 degrees 9 times, that is 1260. So each angle is 140, then sum of 9 angles you will get 1260. Regular means all are in equal, means side and angles. Now here, next one, then first you have to see how many sides are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So one more we have to draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10. So 10 we have to draw. Like this you have to draw. Total 10 sides we have to draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 sides. Here how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 sides. 10 sides means decagon. So this is regular decagon. This is irregular decagon. Irregular decagon. So in a regular decagon we have all 10 sides equal and 10 angles equal. Each angle is equal to 144 degrees. If you add 144 degrees 10 times, then you will get 1440. So regular means all sides are equal and equal, each angle is equal, means all angles and all sides are equal in regular. In irregular means all sides are different and all angles are different. This is the difference between regular and irregular. In irregular, if 3 sided closed polygon means that is a triangle, 4 sided closed means that is quadrilateral, if 5-sided pentagon, 6-sided hexagon, 7-sided heptagon, 8-sided octagon, 9-sided nonagon and 10-sided decagon. Okay, from 3 to 10 sides. So that names and regular, about regular and irregular we discussed. Okay. Now here, formula for interior angle of a polygon. Interior angle. How to find interior angle of a polygon? So that formula is there, interior angle, sum of interior angles is equal to 180 into number of sides minus 2, number of sides minus 2. Suppose for pentagon, so for pentagon we have to find total angles, then how to find? For pentagon, no? So this 180 we have to write as it is into number of sides. In pentagon, so we have 5 sides. How many sides we have? We have 5 sides. So 5 sides we have to write 5 minus 2. 180 into 5 minus 2 is 3. Now 180 into 3. 300, 3 8s are 24, 2 3 54. 540. In pentagon sum of 5 angles 540 degrees. Once you check before we did know, so in pentagon how much sum of 5 angles 540 already we discussed. So 540, how to find? So how to find in a polygon? So one formula is there. So sum of angles is equal to 180 into number of sides minus 2 we have to write. In decagon, how to find? In decagon, 180 into 10 minus 2 we have to take. So why 10 minus 2? In decagon we have 10 sides. So that 10 minus 2 we have to write. 10 minus 2 is 8. 180 into 8 we have to write. Then you will get sum of angles in decagon. So, okay, so this is the formula for finding number of angles in a polygon. Now, angle, each angle in a polygon, then how to find each angle? Suppose in a pentagon each angle how to find? First total interior angles, how much? 540. Total interior angles by number of sides. In a pentagon how many sides we have? 5 sides. 5 ones are 5. So this 40 we have to take at a time. This means we have to keep a 0. 5 8s are 40. 108 degrees. Each angle is 180 degrees in a pentagon. So using these two formulas we can find each angle in a polygon, in a regular polygon, and also we have to find sum of angles in a polygon we have to find. So these two formulas you have to remember. Okay.